Good afternoon, MMTs. What I have before us today is what we call the S&P 500. Yes, it is what you see, a weekly chart. This is a weekly chart of the S&P. So it's very important to understand that the 10-week moving average, which is this aqua blue line, that's at 2085. And this last week, we had a reversal on the weekly, but it was all on Friday. So basically what's going to end up happening now that we're going into the earnings season is we have a very clear picture of this January effect, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks. On the fifth week up, we rallied, we gave it back, we pulled to the support level. The red line is a 20-week simple moving average at 2065. And we're entering the quarterly earnings season. So let's just actually do the following right now. Here is a daily chart on Friday, on a daily chart on that S&P and these upper trend lines that everyone can see here. That's a major wall of resistance on a daily. Once again, I will go over what the 20-day simple moving average is at 2083. That's this red line. The 10-day simple moving average on a daily is at 2091, and we fell through that, and we actually came down here, and we tested where the breakout happened above this half bar. We went straight up, and then the big sell-off had come on Friday. Now, let's go ahead and move over here to the 50-day simple moving average, which is the white line. That's at 2084. And the 100-day simple moving average, which is this yellow line down here, that's where we found that support. And we had rallied up. The volatility is going to increase because of the earnings season. And this is that big daily distribution. So 2064.59 is that 100-day moving average. And what happens on daily moving averages, the 40-day simple, we keep that in there, that's at 2086. So we're starting to fall below there. What we're going to be looking starting tomorrow morning is how we come down. This 100-day simple moving average is where that wall of support was no matter what, and we rallied up. But that selling that came in on Friday that we had called for was a huge sell program. And just to give you an idea on that S&P movement, which is this column right here, the S&P 500 has 30-point movement. And whether that's up or down, it really doesn't matter. It's still a 30-point move. And that is a huge move on the S&P 500. So that's the complete daily range that we had, and 30 points was double the previous day's selling, three times. The prior, on 415, we had a 14 daily range. We've exceeded some of these ranges by three times the amount as far as the reversal goes, and we always know one thing for sure. The U.S. stock markets have had their run. That means that this quarterly earnings season that we're going into is going to be a struggle for these publicly traded companies in the U.S. Another thing I'm going to clearly say about the S&P 500 is the easy money has been made. Buying the dip mentality will stay here as the volatility will increase between the bull and the bear, and it will be a bull and bear fight. So money is moving out of the U.S. and it's going to Europe. And so they're, you know, once again, emerging markets. You've got QE, you've got central bankers around the world that are pumping major stimulus into their exchanges. So once again, I'm going to conclude that daily chart for the S&P 500. And another thing that I'm going to say is there is going to be a lot of turbulence. And basically, when you start breaking down below these simple daily moving averages and the key support level, is going to be the 100-day moving average on that daily. And I'm going to do one more thing just to make sure that a lot of our hedge fund managers that we deal with are clear. So I need to do one thing for them. Hold on one second. This is a monthly chart of the S&P 500. So now we've covered the daily, we've covered the weekly, and now we're doing the monthly. And for a lot of our bigger traders that trade the index, as far as call side, put side, is I want to make it very clear that this is a 3-month move to a high. When we sold off in January, we said what was going to happen in the month of January. I just want to bring back to everybody's attention that when we had started, in such a way that we were covering this S&P. And if you go up here and you type in S&P, just like I'm going to show you, S&P 500, bing, bing, bing. Now, let's talk about the talent. Let's talk about what we did. Let's talk about how we said that S&P 500 was going to get whacked. And it did. And all the trades that are in here on the S&P, you can go, you can click on them, you can see them. They're all here. We called a bottom at that 100-day simple moving average on the S&P when the S&P wanted to rip, and it did. And back over here, you can see here clearly. And I'm just going to tell everybody one more time. I'm going to make this clear. When we talk about what's going to happen, we are telling the world what's going to happen before it even happens. And if you want to be in denial, if you want to be in denial, for you bigger money managers, you're going to get yourself whacked. And you can always call me and I'll figure out a risk trade that we can, you know, put you in the options or whatnot. You click here, you're going to see where that S&P was 2160. And I'm not joking. And this particular setup, of course, was on 325. Today is 419. And guess what? If you haven't got it yet, then if I were you, then I would get here right now and go back and look at all the analysis that was done and what I just said this morning. And I'm not joking for you other money managers that are with us, and that risk is there. That's the S&P 500. So for the people that are in denial, either you're going to break your denial or you're going to get slaughtered. And you're going to get slaughtered. And when I say slaughtered, I mean slaughtered, unfortunately. And so back over here on 4-9, we were talking about the S&P 500 right here. Here it is. Here it is, right in front of your face. I said the index, lower volume back above key daily moving averages. You see the print? You see it? I said weekly buyer strength was very weak. Very weak. Very weak. Very weak. So basically, we went in and we traded the index up to that resistance level, and now we're buying the put options. And I talked about right here on 4-9, you can see that video, it's live. And not only can you see it, you can understand it. There's been 171 views on it, and I would probably say 160 of them are our traders and whatnot. So it's always going to be back to one thing, and it's going to be this. I got one more thing to say. I'm going to talk a little bit about this S&P 100 versus the S&P 500 based on market capitalization. It's the 100 stocks that are the leadership in our economy. So one of the things that I want to make sure is that when we're looking at the S&P 500, we're looking at our 100 called the OEX. And I'm going to put the OEX in here versus the S&P 500 right here. These are all the stocks in the S&P 500 and 100 combined. So they're both weighted in certain indexes and whatnot. What I am going to show is Google had a big gap down. The OEX, this is the S&P 100, Amazon, American Express, Target, Disney, FedEx, and, you know, from there, there wasn't much trading. I'm going to show a monthly chart. And this is the OEX S&P 100, and this is a monthly top end resistance level, and this is how we have come from that January sell off there. That's a monthly. Now when we get over here and we take a look at the S&P 100 index, we're testing on that 100. If that yellow line is that 50-day simple, the white line is the 50-day simple moving average. We went down here. This yellow line right here is 100-day simple moving average. There are mathematical equations that we work with in the high frequency algorithmic model. So that support level is 908.35, and that is that classical reversal on the S&P 100. And I'm also even going to take the time to show some other money managers the following. What I have before us now, MMT, is I got the S&P 400 index. This is what it looks like on a daily simple chart, daily moving averages. And they all have one thing in common. Remember how these indexes are weighted. We've taught this for the last 30 years about how indexes are weighted by market capitalization and short interest. And this particular index, that white line that you see there, that's a 50-day simple moving average right there at 1469. This is the S&P 400 mid-cap index, which is very important. That's the backbone of this economy. And we're testing that 50-day simple moving average. We're below the 10, we're below the 20. These markets are in trouble. Earnings season is starting. So we've covered the S&P 500, we covered the S&P 100, and now we're covering the S&P 400 mid-cap index. And these markets are in trouble. I'm just going to tell everybody right now that later this evening, when I send out, when I have the video manager, once he gets this done, then he's going to blast it out to everybody. And one thing that I can say is that we started with that gap down. This is a very, 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 very important index. And we have the earnings season starting right now. And that's going to be in full bloom in the morning. This is the 400 stocks right here in this. And so it's one of the most important indexes as far as what are the leaderships and what are today's ranges. So once again, I'm concluding the S&P 500, 100, and the S&P 400. And on this particular chart right here, what I will do is I'll just do one more thing that would be helpful, because I want people to see this 400 on a monthly level. This is a monthly chart, and this is what we call blow off top. And not only is it a blow off top on the 400 index, we're overbought and we're going down, and no one's going to stop it. And I'm just going to tell you, the rest of you people out there with your little freak accounts, and you're going to hold this stuff going down. If I were you, I would start thinking about how to get out of positions and not initiate, if you're an investor or whatever you are with markets. We're market makers. And I'm telling you, the volatility is coming back, and it's coming back in a super big way. And I'm going to also show you one last indicator. What I have before us now is called the VIX, the VIX, Volatility S&P 500 VIX. When this goes up, markets sell off. And we went straight up here to 15. And everybody, once again, when we talk about complacency, you want to know what complacency is? It's poison. And why do I say it's poison? Because there isn't enough money that is pushing these indexes to new higher highs. And I just want everyone to understand that the complacency down here on this daily chart on the fear indicator was, and I'll just tell you how it was. It opened at 1597. 1502 was the high, actually, 1397 and 1373. When this goes up, markets go down. When this goes down and comes back down, markets go up. They run invert of each other. And we had a good sell-off when that fear indicator peaked above 16. We're in earnings season. You got the fear indicator. You got everything that you need in this 15-minute series on this S&P 500, 100, 400. And now you have the volatility index to kick it off. So basically on Friday, we gapped and we tested the 50-day, the white line. The green line's a 200-day. And so we put in this bottom right here where people have no fear. They don't. Don't even know what they're doing. And that's what complacency is about. And thank you once again. And I'll have the video manager upload everybody tonight on this 16-minute preview. Good afternoon, everybody. I have what we call the Russell 1000 Index. The 1000 Index here on this daily chart is breaking down. And once again, I will just give everyone a little glimpse of the 1000. These are the stocks. Look at the distribution. Look at the distribution. Look at the selling across the board in that Russell 1000. All the way down. But these are, you know, Amazon was a great short. Google was a great short. Priceline had an $18 move. How wonderful that was. That was more than wonderful. And then, of course, that American Express. And this is just the 1000 index on a daily. I'll go ahead and key in the 50-day simple moving average. That simple day simple moving average is right around 1164. That's the white line. The 10-day simple moving average is 1169, and it's well below it. And then, of course, you're going to have your 40-day moving average, and that's roughly 16. Well, here, we'll just kind of narrow. I mean, 1165, and this is that topping pattern, and we sell down. That white line is where these rallies had happened, and I'm calling for the following, and here's what I'm calling for. And I'm just going to let you know right now, what you need to know is that we're going into the earnings season. It's starting tomorrow morning on 420. And what you need to understand is that the volatility is going to increase. And when I say increase, I mean big time. There's going to be a lot of buying in the after hours market where we make big trades. And all of these high beta stocks, you have all your analysis here. You can go through here. You can do your homework. You can understand that we put out this before anything ever happens. We're not like the rest of the world. Anybody can say something's going to happen after it happened. Come on. That's not talent. That is not talent. Because it's not. And I'm just going to say one thing. Remember, we were down over 300 points on Friday on the Dow. The NASDAQ 100 down 67 points. NASDAQ Composite, which was down 75 handles. And of course, we had a 30 point handle on that S&P. And that meant that people were selling before we're starting the earnings season. Russell 1000 is a very important index. And one of the things about it is that we're going to draw a little trend line right here. And this is that daily chart. And this is where that 100-day simple moving average down there at 1150 is going to be a key support level. Just remember, as we start breaking through these support levels on a daily, on all of these indexes and everything else, and remember, volatility works to the upside, and volatility comes down and it rallies up. Here's another simple trend line, and we broke it. And so the wall of support's at 1150. And I'm going to conclude the Russell 1000 index. And one of the things that I will just show everybody, the thing that we are going to be taking a look at is the fear indicators. And I'm just going to throw this in here real quick. This is called the QQQQ, called the QID. and it's a bear, and it's going higher, and it's above the simple moving averages. I just want people to understand that when markets sell off, you do have a chance to get here and get with this and make money to the upside while everyone else is getting killed. You got a big smile on your face, and life is good. I'm concluding right now the Russell 1000. Good morning to you West Coast people, and good afternoon to my guys in New York, Jersey, South Philly, and other parts of the eastern side of the country. I have the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and I'm going to get back to one thing again for the hedge fund managers and money managers, especially you. Denial is going to ruin you. Denial is going to kill you. The earnings season is starting tomorrow on 420. We're going to have these publicly traded companies that are going to come out, and they're going to have a big challenge in meeting their earnings. And the buy the dip mentality isn't going to go away. But here's what I will say, and we're going to get right down to it right here, right now. This is one huge distribution bar on Friday. I want people to understand the simple 100-day moving average at 17.811. That's this beige line. That's a 100-day moving average. When I get into the 10-day simple moving average, that's at 17.93. When I get into the 20-day simple moving average, and mind you, we went right through every one of these daily simple moving averages on Friday. So what did it mean? Nobody wanted to go home over the weekend long stocks, let alone the challenges and the volatility is even going to get more horrendous starting tomorrow morning on Monday at what date? 420 of 215. So we violated all the moving averages, but just for, I'll just let people know, when we started off right here, this is where we started right here, and we were in a range right here in that Dow. And hold on, and here's what I'm going to show you. Right here, what you need to know is we have all the coverage on the Dow Jones, and it's all here. Here, how about this one? This is when the Dow Jones closed down 200 points, and you can see what data was on 331, the last day of March. And basically what you got was a big whack going down. Yeah, and you had some counter rallies in there. I'm going to encourage everybody to do the following. I'm going to encourage that you go D-O-W space J-O-N-E-S. The last thing I want to see happen to people is that your denial will ruin you. And the buy and hold mentality right now, that volatility is going to increase. We did the last earnings season right here, quarterly reports on the Dow. And you got the Dow up here. And you got all the analysis before the fact. I didn't say after the fact. That doesn't make you money. You got to know why, where, when, and what. And you need to go back through here. And what did I say? What did I say? Dow Jones crushed 332 points down when we called that one on 3-5. The date was 3-10. I'm just going to say that for the remainder part of 2015 and 2016, you have heard, and it is documented. Let's skip the ad right here. So basically on the YouTube, you're going to be able to see right here that we are in a bubble. And it's called a bubble. And it's going to continue to go through 2015 and 2016. I'm not joking, and I'm not wrong either. In your mind, who knows what you're thinking? This is real. These are the facts, findings, and conclusionary analysis that does not lie. And it's not lying because we're here for our bigger clients, our smaller clients that are trading our capital. It really doesn't matter. What does matter is that when we take a look at this particular movement, every time that we had that counter rally, we came down and we tested that 100 simple day moving average on the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Right now, though, guess what? When I said volatility is coming, you heard what I said in the month of January. You heard what I said in the rally in February. You heard what I said. You heard it. And you've seen it in March. And now, hey, guess what, pal? Markets are going to test their moving averages. I'm just going to tell everybody. Money is going to move out of the U.S. So the people that never got in the rally in 2009, shame on you. Bigger money managers and hedge fund managers are going to move to Europe. And they're going to start buying Europe. They're going to start buying the Chinese. They're going to start buying the ETFs in emerging markets. That means that the percent level of people buying the dip will be diminishing in value. So let's just do it one more favor for everybody. We know that the earnings season is starting. This is a monthly chart. We've gone parabolically up. If we go back to 2000, I was there every day. I've been around here 30 years. I called that top. I shut down a lot of trading floors. I called that 2007 and the big crash. We're over 6 years into this, what we call expansionary stimulated model by Federal Reserve governors around the world. So the U.S. started it off like always. You got Europe going that way. You got everybody going to be accommodative in their country and their monetary policy. This is a major resistance level on the DJ. One of the other things that I want you to understand is the DJI, which I already put. And the thing I want you to see is only, we'll call it the Dirty 30. It's 30 stocks, market capitalization weighted out of the 30 top countries, the countries that we put ADRs on, and then the U.S. here. And we're going into the earnings season. I'll just let people understand that this Dow Jones, I'm going to show this on a monthly level, and this is an internet index called the ECM.X. And basically, there's a lot of problems with it. And it's got your internet stocks. You got Google, you got Amazon, you got Twitter, but you got all of these other companies that are weighted in this Dow Jones. One of the bigger things that I'm going to cover next is how these transports are not participating as they should be in the rally. So we're going to go back to the Dow Jones composite itself, and we're going to be into the earnings season here. Let's pull this back up and see if we can get that thing populated. Back to the monthly chart. The top at resistance is a wall of resistance on a monthly chart. 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, and now we're about four months here. So at the end of the calendar month in this earnings season, we're going to see what these markets are made of. And it's going to be a wild, wild ride. And one of the other things that I was really wanting to make clear to Johnny is that with your trading group, you need to go ahead and gapple up on some of the emerging market ETFs for the upside, and then selling the U.S. on the downside. That way you got the long side in Europe, you got the long side in Hong Kong, and you got the long side in various different emerging markets where capital inflows from the United States of America. Hey, knock, knock, who's home? That's where the money flow is going to be moving. And the volatility will extremely get higher and higher. And it's a trader's market is what it is. So there is the Dirty 30 on that Dow Jones. And one thing that's always important to us, whether you're a little novice investor or whoever you are, whatever your market participation is, you need to go in here and you need to do your homework. And if you're not willing to do your homework, then don't cry about your losses.